for ovens and most regions are essentially open.
I'm a software accessibility consultant and cat person. One of my hobbies is creating short films. I am certified by Apple in Final Cut Pro and by Blackmagic Design in DaVinci Resolve. Here you see me using one of my favorite accessibility features, head pointer, to balance and color grade a shot that I'm working on. I'm not wearing anything on my face. Head pointer is using the Mac's built-in camera, computer vision, and machine learning technology to track the angle of my head and my facial expressions. With this, I'm able to very quickly move the pointer around the screen and manipulate all the controls needed for advanced video editing and effects. For a complete introduction to head pointer, my dad and I wrote a training manual. Download Using Your Head for free on the Apple Bookstore.
No, that is another one of my favorite areas. A head tracking on iPad.
Head tracking is found in Settings, under Accessibility, Switch Control. Here, you can assign different actions to facial expressions. I like to assign the tap action to open mouth, and the home action to stick out tongue. Once I'm ready, I open the scanner menu, scan to the head tracking item in the menu and select it. This activates head tracking. I'm having a little trouble controlling the pointer at the moment, due to all my movements. So, I'm going to switch back to item mode, go back into head tracking settings and change the pointer tracking mode to when facing screen edges. In this mode, head tracking only cares about the angles of my face and not my movements. That's much better. I can then stick my tongue out to activate home on my iPad. In Settings, I have assigned the Direct Touch action to iBlink. Let's see how this helps me drag objects around the screen, using only facial expressions and head movements. Once again, I use my switch on my headrest, activate the scanner menu, and choose head tracking. Now, I tilt my head over to the left a little to make the cursor move in that direction. I open my mouth to tap the adjustment button, then tilt my head a little over to the right to move to the exposure controls. This image was taken near dusk, so I don't want it to be too bright. Head tracking really allows me to move through these controls quickly. I am able to try different adjustments and push and pull them, so I can effortlessly see what works and what doesn't. I'm very much making things up as I go here, as I sit in front of you fine audience. But, I'm having lots of fun. iPhone and iPad recently introduced a new switch control feature called Sound Actions. Sound Actions is a feature which is meant to be used instead of, or in addition to, a switch control switch. Here I am using sounds to turn on my lights in the Home app. iPhone and iPad recently introduced a new switch control feature called Sound Actions. Sound Actions is a feature which is meant to be used instead of, or in addition to, a switch control switch. In Settings, add a new switch to switch control. Here, you can choose a new option called Sound. There are 14 different sounds that can be used as a switch. At the top of the screen, tap the Practice button. This will allow you to attempt to make each sound so you can practice which one may work the best. Tap on the sound to hear an example pronunciation. For me, the and la sounds seem to work really well, so I will choose these. I have assigned the move to next item to la, and select item to ah. Now, as I say la, the move to next item activates and the switch control cursor moves forward. When I say ah, switch control selects the focused item. The idea of accessing the world through scanning software is pretty ingrained in me. Over the past year though, there has been some fascinating changes. I'm now at the point where I sometimes don't even use switch control to access my iPad. Wait, what? With the new pointer feature, you can interact with your iPad using a variety of point-and-click devices. These include mice, joysticks, trackpads, all the way up to eye-tracking devices. iPadOS 15 now supports third-party eye-tracking devices, making it possible for people to control iPad using just their eyes. Eye trackers have not worked well for me in the past, but this one is amazing. I really love it. Now, it's really easy to start typing, using only my eyes.
Let me show you how this works.
I am currently performing a calibration. Once done, the cursor follows my eyes. Since I can't touch my device, what should I do when I want to change apps or access the rest of my iPad? With assistive touch, you can access the POC to reveal a menu where you can access actions such as home, volume controls, and so much more. Under pointer control and settings, I'm going to make the pointer size a little bigger and then add color so it is easier to see. This brings us to the next really cool feature, Dwell. Up until this point, I've been using the switch on my headrest to tap things. When I enable Dwell, though, assistive touch will do this for me. All I have to do is look at a part of the screen for 1 second. After this, assistive touch will perform a tap. One of my favorite features is the ability to wake my iPad just by looking at it. In combination with Dwell, this means I can drive my wheelchair up to the iPad. It will automatically wake, and I can just start using it with my eyes.
It is especially important when we are on islands to water. If you can't completely control your communicator, maybe in the world, not the same of the this or you're doing on this darkness will be done. So, let me show you two promotional pieces on my bad OS that I could not live without.
This is one of my three cats, James Bond. In the afternoon, she likes to jump up on my wheelchair to let me know she's hungry. She is a very smart cat and I wouldn't put anything past her, including being able to see what's on my screen. Let's look at how I can secure my device against a pesky cat using the passcode options and Face ID. Whenever I want to, I can change my passcode. I can choose to use a 6-digit numeric passcode, or a custom alphanumeric passcode. This iPad has Face ID. Face ID is the reason this is the most secure communication device I have ever used. I can have the confidence that no one else can get into my device if they don't have the passcode. I can also trust that I don't have to physically enter my passcode every time. This means I can set an auto lock time for as short as 2 minutes, and not have to worry about unlocking it all the time. On iOS, I have the ability to password protect and share personal and sensitive communications using secure documents via a shared link. I have complete control over who sees it and when. Here is how quickly I can do this, using eye tracking. I have typed up some notes in the Free Pages app from Apple. To finish them off, I'm going to add a cute kitty cat photo. In this case, I have my switch on my headrest connected to port 1 in the back of TD Pilot. This is the equivalent of a left click on a normal mouse. Once I'm happy with my document, I can tap the Collaborate button. Here, I can add a specific person with an email or phone number. Under Share Options, I can choose who can access the document, set permissions, and add a password. For now though, I will choose Copy Link. Then, I switch over to the Messages app. Finally, I can paste in the link and send it to my friend, family or healthcare professional. And, at any time, I can choose to stop sharing my document.
And if for more than I prefer, I think I told you to help you learn.
Yeah.
Yeah.